When we make decisions in a relationship, we sometimes have the feeling if we are doing the right or wrong thing in that relationship. It is normal to feel that way as a human. But knowing we have that confidence in our heart, that God has backed up that relationship, then we have the peace of God in our heart. However, when you are in a relationship that is devoid of the peace and joy of God in your heart, and you have a gut feeling that you are making a big mistake in choosing your spouse, then you should turn to God in prayer. God is surely going to show you a sign by not giving you the comfort you truly seek in that relationship, because He knows that relationship is not the right one for you, and that you are treading the wrong path. However, it is important to have a strong belief in God. Any relationship that is not giving you the peace and love of God is not meant for you. God is not a God of confusion. If you truly have the Holy Spirit of God in you, then you would have the peace and joy of God in your heart that you are doing the right thing because the Holy Spirit would give you that assurance. However, when you want to make the wrong move in a relationship, then He would convict you and make sure you do not fall in the wrong hands. In conclusion, you must seek the face of God and open your heart to His instructions when involved in a relationship. It is also important you prayerfully ask for His guidance, as you can know the warning signs of a bad relationship. There is that moment you as a human feel you have found the right person or the right choice for you for a relationship that can lead to marriage. Most relationships start on a very sweet and perfect note. However, time begins to reveal the cracks and shortcomings of such a relationship that will likely bring it to a premature end. Others rush into relationships and marriages because they were so desperate for one thing or the other, which could be love, money, emotional stability, and even children. Regardless of how you feel about that person now, have you taken the time to study the person? Do you know his or her attitude spiritually, financially, and so on? Is such a person ready to be committed and sacrificial to that relationship? Is he or she emotionally strong to handle the rigors of relationships and eventually marriages? Many young couples today, especially believers of God, enter into a relationship without asking and seeking the will of God concerning whom they are in a relationship with. Others think they have the power to change and conform their intended spouse to their will and end up patching things up till they are eventually married, only for them to realize that such person or partner rather got worse than ever. God has indeed given us the free will to choose whom we want, but it is only on the condition that such person is a true child of God. The Bible in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 22 tells us to flee from any appearance of evil. If that partner you are about to get married or be in a relationship with is not born again, then you have nothing to do with such a person. Bad company corrupts good manners. It is not in your place to change someone. That should be left to the power of the Holy Spirit. If you are in this kind of relationship, then God will give you a sign by opening your spiritual eyes. This could be through the studying of His Word, or could be through a dream or vision. God could further open your eyes through your spiritual leaders or spiritual brothers and sisters. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 17, verse 16, "Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles?" Your spouse or intending partner may appear like a good, loving, and innocent person, but through the power of the Holy Spirit, you would be able to identify and know if they are truly meant to be for you. This means you have to walk in the Spirit of God, because only then can God open your spiritual eyes to reveal these things to you. A relationship that is not firmly founded in the will and grace of God is bound to fail. As a believer in Christ, when you find yourself in a relationship with someone who does not share your beliefs, values, and commitment, then it is a sign from God to call such a relationship to quit. Any relationship that you and your partner have different ideologies and beliefs will cause conflict and unrest in the relationship. This is why it is usually advised to marry your best friend. Marry someone you can confide in without being afraid of what his or her reaction is. Marry someone that is considerate and loving and caring towards you. Don't marry for the sake of love or passion. Those can't take you far in a relationship. Marry someone who shares your beliefs and values and who is ready to help you achieve your goals. The moment you feel trapped in a relationship or you feel your conscience is compromised in that relationship, then it is a red flag that you are in the wrong relationship. You both must be committed to serving God and living according to His ways. When you begin to do things in a relationship that compromises your faith, then it is time to let go of that relationship and wait on God for the right relationship. The Bible tells us to be yoked with unbelievers, 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 14. So you have nothing to do with someone who does not share the feeling and love of God with you. Rather, they can make you lose sight of your purpose here on earth, so beware of this kind of people in your relationship and your life. There are bound to be arguments and fights in a relationship, but the moment the fight and argument in the marriage are almost constant, then it shows you are not meant for one another and that you do not have a vibe with each other. Fighting and arguments all the time in a relationship, either both you and your spouse are not mature enough or the relationship is getting toxic too quickly. Any relationship in which you are physically abused or you both have to be violent should be avoided immediately. The same goes for any relationship where you are emotionally blackmailed. That is not the will and plan of God for you for a relationship. No matter how beautiful and lovely you both seem to be for each other, there must be that joy and peace of God in that relationship. That means God must come first in that relationship. It should be noted that any relationship where you endure the devil your spouse or partner does to you will only increase when you get married. So don't be driven by the lies of the devil that your partner would change after you both are married. No, it is likely for such a partner to get even worse. So run away from any relationship that does not give you the peace and joy of the Lord, but rather makes you fight and argue all the time. Being in a relationship is not just about companionship and having great sexual intimacy and the like. Marriage was also made so you can both fulfill God's purpose on earth. However, the instant you begin to see yourself diminishing in growth in every area of your life, then it shows that the relationship is not meant for you in the first place. The relationship is meant to make you grow spiritually, socially, and in every way possible. Any relationship that stifles your growth and does not make you achieve your God's given potential should be avoided. The relationship is all about sacrifices too. You must have a partner who is ready to sacrifice himself or herself for your well-being and for you to achieve your godly goals and desire. When in a relationship, there are sure to be some things that would reduce drastically in your life. The way you relate with friends and family would be cut down a little, but this should be done because you are now devoting yourself to your relationship. Regardless of this should be done with a good aim that you are making your relationship a better one. Your partner should not even alienate you from your relationship with your friends and family. Rather, they help you enhance it more. So you need to be careful of any relationship that your potentials seem to diminish rather than increase. Be careful of the sacrifices you make for your partner. Make sure they are worth it at the end of time. Also, ask yourself if your partner is willing to make such sacrifices for you. If the answer is no, then you need to leave such a relationship as soon as possible.